Restoration is a perfectly valid school of magic. You consider Restoration a valid school of magic, worthy of study, don't you? Don't you? Good. Good. Not that I require validation, of course. It can make life difficult when one's colleagues fail to recognize the research one engages in. Well, no, not really. Not directly, I mean. But I know things are being said behind my back. I'm quite aware of what's going on here, and I will not stand for it.
Welcome to the college.
Yes, just a brief overview of our facilities. Are you ready?
Let's move faster. The sun is...
What you learn here will last you a lifetime. Several, if you're talented.
Yes? Yes, but when I was here, it wasn't so... crumbly. This used to be a city. I wonder what happened here.
I don't want... You are now in the Arcanium, of which I am in charge. It might as well be my own little plane of oblivion. Disrupt my Arcanium, and I will have you torn apart by angry Atronox. Now, do you require assistance?
I need to find a moth.
A moth priest? What in oblivion do you need a moth priest for? Fine, fine. No need to get your britches in a twist. The obvious answer is to go to the Imperial City. The moth priests make their home in the White Gold Tower. Sometimes they go out looking for Elder Scrolls. Lucky for you, there's a moth priest in Skyrim right now, doing just that. He stopped in to do some research in the library, then left for Dragonbridge. If you hurry, you might catch him there.
It's no secret that the college's reputation in Skyrim is tainted.
Winter man.
Are you a soldier? One day, I'm going to be a soldier.
By the...
Where'd you come from? That'll teach you.
Hmm.
But my master is dead, and his enemies will pay.
Thank you.
far, this hasn't been too bad. It's lonely exploring by myself, though.
But my master...
He's there.
Stop! I yield!
That wasn't me.
I owe you a debt for the timely rescue. I'm quite all right, thanks to you. Dexian Evicus is my name. I'm a moth priest of the White Gold Tower. These vampires claimed they had some purpose in store for me, but they wouldn't say what. Probably hoping to ransom me, the fools. You do? All right then. Enough mysteries. You have an Elder Scroll. Remarkable. If my knowledge of history serves me, I recall that the Dawn Guard was an ancient order of vampire hunters. I will be happy to assist you with your Elder Scroll. Just tell me where I need to go. Very well. I'll hurry on my way there before more of those vampires turn up.
Some rest.
Do you have a moment to talk? That moth priest, Dexian, he said we needed two other Elder Scrolls. I think I know where we can start looking. People in your little crew would just as soon kill me as talk to me. That doesn't exactly make me want to open up. I got a warmer welcome from my father, and that's saying something. Ever since he decided to make that prophecy his calling, we kind of drifted apart. I don't even think he sees me as his daughter anymore. I'm just... a means to an end. We need to find my mother, Valerica. She'll definitely know where it is. And if we're lucky, she actually has it herself. The last time I saw her, she said that she'd go somewhere safe. Somewhere that my father would never search. Other than that, she wouldn't tell me anything. But the way she said it, someplace he would never search. It was cryptic, yet she called attention to it. Maybe. What I can't figure out is why she said it that way. Besides, I can't imagine a single place my father would avoid looking. And he's had all this time, too. Any ideas? Almost makes sense. There's a courtyard in the castle. I used to help her tend a garden there. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place. Too peaceful. Oh, absolutely. But my mother's not a coward. That is, I don't think we'll actually trip over her there, but it's worth a look. True. But I know a way we can get to the courtyard without arousing suspicion. There's an unused inlet on the northern side of the island that was used by the previous owners to bring supplies into the castle. An old escape tunnel from the castle exits there. I think that's our way in. It's around the side of the castle. Let's move.
Courtyard.
I'm telling you, there's something strange with the moon dial. If I had to guess, I'd say the moment Mother fled the castle, Father went on a rampage. Knowing him, anything at all that reminded him of her was just destroyed. It appears that way. I suppose he wanted to put the past behind him. Perhaps if he had spent more time with us, he would have recognized the beauty for himself. Well, as far as I'm aware, it's the only one in existence. The previous owners of the castle had a sundial in the courtyard, and obviously that didn't appeal to my mother. She persuaded an elven artisan to make some improvements. You can see the plates that show the phases of the moons, Masser and Secunda. And that's the thing. What's the point of a moon dial? I always wondered why she didn't just have the whole thing ripped out. But she loved it. I don't know. I guess it's like having a piece of art, if you're into that sort of thing. Hard to say. Maybe if we found the missing crests, we could figure it out. Look around for the missing crests. Even in this mess, they should stick out.
did you come from? Who's there? Show yourself.
Thank you.
did you come from?
We're getting close, I'm sure of it. We're getting close. I'm sure of it.
This is probably like the final room or something. Sure looks like.
Where'd you come from?
Thank you.
We're getting close. I'm sure of it. This has to be it. I knew she was deep into necromancy. I mean, she taught me everything I know. But I had no idea she had a setup like this. Look at all this. She must have spent years collecting these components. And what's this thing? I'm not sure about this circle, but it's obviously something. Let's take a look around. There has to be something here that tells us where she's gone. My mother was meticulous about her research. If we can find her notes, there might be some hints in there.
Okay.
I had no idea her laboratory even existed. She had an alchemy set up in her drawing room, but nothing that even comes close to what's here. Looking at the equipment and materials, it looks like she was trying to advance her necromancy. I don't know. Certainly not longevity. Kind of a waste of time for a vampire. I remember she used to keep a small journal. See if you can dig it. Keep searching for her notes. She probably had a journal or something.
Good night.
Keep searching for her notes. She probably had a journal or something. Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood. Of course. What is it? I've been asking myself the same thing since we came back to the castle. She was so sure of what we did to my father. I couldn't help but go along with her. I never thought of the cost. Neither do I. She always seemed happy before we heard the prophecy. Then it all changed. She became a different person. They both did. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I just didn't expect anyone to care how I felt about her. Thank you. Are we ready then? All right, here goes. Soul Cairn is a tiny sliver of Oblivion, the realm of the Daedra. It's ruled by unseen beings known as the Ideal Masters. Honestly, I don't know. Necromancers are always interested in souls, though, so that probably has some kind of interest. Nobody really knows. As far as I've heard, no one's seen them and returned to Tamriel to tell about it. I've read stories. Stories about fools that manage to communicate with them. You give the Ideal Masters souls, they give you powers to summon the undead. It's all very businesslike. Because most of the stories end with the Ideal Masters duping the Necromancers, who end up dead or wishing they were dead. I'm ready when you are. Are you all right? That looked painful. Now that I think about it, I should have expected that. Sorry. It's hard to describe. The Soul Cairn is... well, hungry, for lack of a better word. It's trying to take your life essence as payment. There might be, but I don't think you're going to like it. Vampires aren't counted among the living. I could probably go through there without a problem. Not your first choice, I guess? Maybe. We could just pay the toll another way. It wants a soul, so we give it a soul. Yours. My mother taught me a trick or two. I could partially soul trap you and offer that gem to the Ideal Masters. It might be enough to satisfy them. It would make you a bit weaker when we travel through the Soul Cairn, but we might be able to fix that once we're inside. Maybe. I'm sorry. I wish I knew a better way, something that would be easier for you. Just know that whatever path you choose, I won't think any less of you. Sometimes things just have to be done. I know that better than anybody. Have you made up your mind? No, this isn't an easy choice. Take your time. Are you sure? I'm willing to turn you, but you need to think it through. You've become the very thing you've sworn to destroy. I don't know how the Dawn Guard will react. I understand. Take your time. Are you sure? I'm willing to do it, but you need to think it through. You'll remain mortal, but you'll find yourself weakened within the Soul Cairn. I know this is difficult for you. I hope you trust me. I'd never do anything that could hurt you. Thank you. Let's not waste any more time then. I promise to make this as painless as possible. Hold still.
No one ever escapes. There is no escape. Why would you even try? This is no place for you.
Imagine choosing to come here. My mother must have been terrified. Look at the sky. What kind of place is this? Just what my mother told me. I've also studied a little bit on my own, but there's not much. When something is trapped in a soul gem, and then the energy is used for powering an enchantment, the remnants are sent here. Well, I think it's specifically the black ones. I don't know if the Soul Cairn takes just any leftovers. Look at this place. Do you think anything would want to live here? The only things that can survive here are the Ideal Masters, the undead, and the souls themselves. Well, if you want to call that living. I don't think anyone's ever met the Ideal Masters. I'm not even sure anyone knows what they look like. They could be underground, flying above us.
Flying.
They might be the ground, I have no idea.
They're giant soul gems.
Lots of theories. Some say they feed on them like I feed on blood. Others think they use them as payment to an even higher power. Almost like a currency. A very strange currency. Whatever they're doing with them, they've been harvesting for millennia. No telling how many souls are trapped here. Look around you. There are some extremely powerful undead here. Even a necromancer as seasoned as my mother would be willing to spend years trying to gain access to them. Exactly. It's a lost art. Most necromancers just raise up whatever bodies are nearby. A simple trick, really. Child's play. But bringing something from the Soul Cairn gives you something much more powerful. Now, that's usually the trick. It's possible to do it through a simple portal. But to finalize the deal, you have to travel here yourself. And most of them never come back. Terrible for the dead who end up here for eternity. Seems awful. Like they're still